This is BFBS Television. West Germany. Among the NATO forces based here are 70,000 servicemen from the British Army and the Royal Air Force. With postings to Germany sometimes lasting several years, accommodation for their wives and families is necessary, along with other special facilities for the British forces abroad. The military population, spread over an area of about 10,000 square miles, totals roughly 165,000. One of the special facilities is VHS Radio, which has its main studios in Cologne.
Broadcasting service in Germany and also in West Berlin.
BBC News, this is
Tom Scanlon. Two members of the Irish Justice and Peace Commission, the group which had...
BFBS broadcasts a wide range of programmes and information 24 hours a day in stereo.
...in Paderborn with a grand display of music and marching in the Inselberg Stadium starting at 8 o'clock. What a feast for the senses! And what good sense it is to take part in the feasts!
The success of the radio network led to the proposal for a television service as far back as 1959. Various ideas emerged, such as using time on the German third TV channel, sending video cassettes to the garrisons, and even broadcasting from an aircraft over Germany. It took another 15 years before BFBS television eventually went on the air in September 1975. And we'll show you now how we bring 8 hours of programmes to your screen every day. We'll move out of this familiar continuity studio, which, it may surprise you to learn, is part of our control centre in the London Weekend Television premises at Wembley in England. And it's in this area that London Weekend Television engineers record all the programmes you see on BFBS television in Germany. BBC and ITV programmes are recorded at the same time as they're seen by viewers in Britain. When ITV programmes have been recorded, the commercial breaks are edited out using two videotape machines and an editing unit designed by one of our engineers. Deciding which programmes to record is difficult with only four videotape or VTR machines. If these two are editing, this is recording from BBC One and this from BBC Two, then obviously we can't record from ITV at the same time. The selection's made by our program planner at the BFBS headquarters in central London. He chooses the programs from advance information supplied by the TV organisations. We try to keep a balance roughly equal to the output of BBC One, BBC Two and ITV. Most UK-produced programmes are available, though American series need special clearance, which cannot always be arranged.
Hello, Columbia Pictures. This is BFBS TV here. Could we have clearance for the new series of Spider-Man, Benson and Soap, please?
After choosing the programmes, we decide on which days they're to be shown. However, last-minute changes made by the BBC and ITV cannot always be predicted.
Because World in Action has been extended now to 50 minutes this week, which means we'll have to drop the program. I suggest we take Knot's Landing a little later and drop Sky at night for that night. Can you fix that with Sixth Sense?
The program planner's assistant provides Sixth Sense with all the times and publicity details.
Otherwise, Thursday should be the same, starting with Play School and Blue Peter.
Now, our schedules office upstairs has allocated VTR3 to record Blue Peter from BBC One at 17.05.
This is BBC One.
Blue
Although most of our programmes come from BBC and ITV, we do make some of our own. And this is the control room for our small studio, which has two cameras remotely controlled from this panel. This mixer panel controls the sound and vision that's fed to one of the VTR machines for recording. Now we need to be able to select cameras, lights, microphones, taped music, records, sound cartridge tapes, and our electronic typewriter. Just outside the control room, this video cartridge machine plays short tape items such as program trailers. These telecine machines play back films, and slides are shown from this device. Programs we make in the studio are scheduled for transmission in the same way as those from BBC and ITV. Now, deciding how to link the programs is among the duties of our senior presentation assistant, whom you might recognize as one of our presenters, Nicole Raymond.
So, I've got the next 2 weeks' programs from the program planner. We know the timings of most of the programs, and we've established the times at which they'll be shown. We show a lot of trailers. Some of these come from the ITV networks, and some of them we make here. And part of my job is to decide where those trailers should go in the evening's viewing. For instance, I would show a clip for a forthcoming comedy programme after a comedy show. Once the evening's viewing has been scheduled, then I hand it all over to the two announcers who are on duty today, Keith Martin and Guy Francis.
Well, there are six of us announcers here at BFBS Television, and at the moment, Keith and myself, we're typing scripts for our respective evening announcements. And I've got an announcement here where I want to talk about a play which comes from the BBC. And each week, the BBC and ITV companies give us press releases with full details of their programmes. And on about a full page of foolscap here, I've got full details of this play. Obviously, it's too much for a sort of 20-second announcement. I find I can only sort of speak for 20 seconds before I start forgetting my lines anyway. So I'll take the salient points out of this and then type them onto this script, and then I hope I've got an announcement. And in fact, I see Keith's finished his script, so he'll be in the studio first.
See you late next. Stand by, Keith. 3, 2, 1, cue.
Hello, and if this is your first time with us...
Stand by, VGR 5.
Standing
by.
First,
four,
here's Kurt.
Three.
Two.
Special guest
one,
for tomorrow.
On the Muppet Show, we have music and comedy, and our guest is Debbie Harry.
Yeah! Stand by, Keith, the voiceover.
Fun for the whole family on the Muppet Show. At ease.
Cue voiceover.
The Muppets, tomorrow evening at 6:10. Then Jim will fix it for some, starting at 7:00 tomorrow. Now comments on one of those programmes and some of our others in Mailbag.
Hey, oh yes, wait a minute, Mr. Postman.
Viewers' letters of criticism are aired in Mailbag, one of the short productions from our studio. Birthday greetings are featured between children's programmes every day in Birthday Time, presented by our regular announcers.
Lots of love from your mummy and daddy and your baby sister Emma Louise, and they hope you've had a nice day today and enjoy your presents.
Corinna Schnabel teaches useful words and phrases in Instant German.
Was kostet das? Was kostet das?
Our studio interviews have included many well-known personalities and senior commanders from the Royal Air Force and from the Army. Everything we've recorded, programs, announcers, Birthday Time, comes through the tape library before being sent to Germany and replayed on air. Now we've about 1,400 of these tapes altogether, of which roughly half are in Germany or in transit at any one time. About 100 tapes a week are delivered to the BFBS television unit at Joint Headquarters Rhein-Dahlen. Outside is the mobile control room from which the tapes were broadcast until very recently. It was from this mobile that the service started from Celle in 1975, moving to Verl in 1978, and finally to the headquarters in July 1980. Unknown to viewers and without any break in transmission, much of the equipment was reinstalled, together with all this new machinery, which you can hear, in this more permanent accommodation only a few weeks ago. And now at last, the small number of staff who work here have the conditions they deserve. They are the videotape operators, who light up the programs and check them for transmission. The engineers who maintain and operate the equipment. The presenters who preview the programs, start the tapes, and make live topical announcements in sound only.
And it takes on VTF 3.
In the mine and core areas, it'll be cloudy at first with showers after midday. It'll feel cool with the temperature rising to 7 degrees. Jimmy Tarbuck takes the bets on winner takes all.
From tomorrow, this control room takes on an additional role by feeding programs direct from the UK via the live link to our transmitter chain and to your set. Someone who has been deeply involved in the UK to Germany link almost from the start is the TV project officer in Germany, Major Bernard Strange of the Royal Signals.
The live link is a line of sight microwave radio relay system that starts at the London Control Centre, Wembley, and goes down through Kent to Dover, across the channel to the French PTT station at Vienne, on into Belgium, where the RTT take it then for us through the country to a place called Heltren. At the moment, that station is yet to be built, so we are having a temporary routing before that arrives and takes us into Brunsum and then to the network input point at GHQ Rheindahlen.
Does this mean the link is now complete?
No, not exactly. Contractually, we've got a great deal yet to do. But because of our anxiety to get the live link through, Marconi have been able to establish a radio path for us so that you can actually use it.
So what you're saying, Bernd, is that what we're getting us from tomorrow is in the way of a bonus?
It is entirely bonus, and as it stands, we contractually have handed it over to us.
And what's still outstanding?
There are two stations still outstanding on the network, one at Dusseldorf and one at Schwarzenmoor, which covers Bad Einhausen and Bad Gofield. We are trying desperately to get that in by Christmas so that the customers can actually have Christmas television. But Dusseldorf, the problem is slightly more difficult because we have yet to get permission to build the tower.
So what does this mean for you as a viewer? The controller of BFBS television, Pat Pashbar.
This is the moment we've been waiting for a long time. And I must confess, now it's upon us, we all feel a certain tingling in our fingertips at the prospects that lie in front of us. You see, apart from the royal wedding, which had its own special problems last year, we've never before joined a UK network for a live transmission before. And there's no doubt about it, it's going to make the whole of our presentation and planning operation more difficult. Up to now, with all the programmes pre-recorded, it hasn't mattered too much if we run a couple of minutes late during the course of an evening. Irritating, certainly, but not a disaster. Well, that's going to change. Now, from tomorrow, we aim to bring you two live news broadcasts each evening from Monday to Friday. And they will be the ITN News at 6:45 local time and the BBC Main News of the evening at 10 o'clock local time. Germany, of course, is 1 hour ahead of the United Kingdom. Now, the news pattern at the weekends will vary, just as it does in the UK, and we haven't yet finalised those times yet. Now, the next major effect of the live link is going to be on sport. And from next Saturday, the 18th of December, we aim to relay Grandstand from BBC One, the whole of the Grandstand programme. And there's no doubt about it that the introduction of these programmes is going to be like a breath of fresh air into our schedules. It's an actual marvellous, exciting step forward. As I said, our problems become more complex. We now have two fixed points to aim for each evening, and it isn't going to be easy. One of the problems is that when we go to press with our programme details, we don't always know the precise duration of those programmes. But whatever the problems, we simply have to get into the news on time. It's not going to wait for us. And there's going to be a great responsibility on the Rheindahlen staff, the Art of Vision staff in Germany, whom you very seldom see, but who are, if you like, those at the sharp end. And they're going to be, in the first few months, the ones responsible for bringing in the live UK transmissions. We hope it's all going to run smoothly, but if we do have a rough edge here or there in the first few days, I hope you'll be patient and try to understand the tension and all of the effort that's going on behind the scenes. And perhaps, above all, the total dedication of everyone who's involved in trying to get it right.
Eventually, we shall be transmitting between 15 and 20 hours of programmes live every week. Some will still have to be recorded because many programmes overlap on the UK channels, and we'll build up to our maximum live service during the course of next year. For the moment, tomorrow's the big day, and I hope that you'll be looking forward as much as we are to the first live news transmissions from ITN at 6:45 and from BBC One at 10 o'clock, local time, tomorrow evening. Live news on BFBS television from tomorrow.
This is BFBS Television, a division of the Services Sound and Vision Corporation. And now, for the very first time, we cross live to London and ITN for the news. The time here in Germany is 6:45.
The news at 5:45 with Michael Nicholson.
Ulster and mainland police alert as Inler threatens revenge. The women of Greenham Common picket a second day, and Poland's military rulers to ease martial law from New Year's Eve. An air base. Well, before we say goodnight, we'd like to say hello to a lot of new viewers. That's to British servicemen and families stationed in West Germany. 160,000 of you, we're told. Well, every evening from now on, you can see our news at 5:45. That's 6:45 your time, live from our studios at ITN House in London's West End, direct to Rheindahlen, Mönchengladbach. It's another television news first from ITV's engineers and from those boffins in the Royal Signals. So, welcome. And that's the news from 5:45 this Monday evening. We'll be seeing you all tomorrow. From me, good evening.
In 25 minutes, there's a lot of bull and a pat on the back when Arthur invites Terry out on a country jaunt in the series Minder. This is BFBS Television, a division of the Services Sound and Vision Corporation. Now, for the first time, live from the BBC, the main news of the evening, with the local time at 10 o'clock.
The peace women blockade Greenham Common. The government say you're helping the Russians. Top alert in Northern Ireland. There could be a new terrorist onslaught. The mother of a child raped twice says the law is not tough enough. And for the first time, a woman joins the men who run English tennis. Say hello to a new group of viewers 700 miles away. For the first time, 160,000 British servicemen and their families in West Germany have been able to watch the 9 o'clock news live from London. We're reaching them via a special microwave link involving some 17 relay points across six countries and ending in Mönchengladbach. The link's been built by the Royal Signals Corps at a cost to the Ministry of Defence of around £20 million. The signal is even picked up by British troops in West Berlin. An army spokesman there said it was marvellous to see BBC News in Berlin 102 miles behind the Iron Curtain.
Now, for the first time, live from the BBC, the main news of the evening, with the local time at 10 o'clock.
And among our new viewers, Sergeant and Mrs. Nick Bowle and their friends from the Royal Ordnance Corps. So to Sergeant Bowle in Mönchengladbach and to all the rest of you, good night.